Hi everyone, thanks for joining us today. Today we're going to be walking everyone through a little bit about the Wave Control, SMP2 field meter, as well as the associated probes. We're going to go ahead and start with talking a little bit about the meter itself, some of the different connections, how to adjust the different probes onto the end of it. Then we're going to go ahead and move on to the display, walking through some of the different parameters you can change, as well as the measurement options and measurement modes. And then finally, we'll go ahead and we'll walk through the software, get everything connected, as well as installing the necessary drivers and updating the system as necessary. All right, so now let's go ahead and let's get started and let's walk through a little bit about the SMP2 field meter and how to make some of the necessary connections you might need to make. Okay, here you're going to find the bottom side of the SMP2 field meter. Starting on the left side, you'll see your fiber optic connection, and you will see a gray and kind of a bluish gray indicated around the two different connections. So this corresponds to the fiber optic cabling, which I'll show you right here. And one thing you do want to be sure of is that these are properly spaced apart. Over time during shipping, these can kind of get bent, so you just want to be sure that those are spaced correctly. So now let's go ahead and place it in the associated slot. You should hear it click into place, just like that. Should you not hear that click, you may not have a good connection, and that's going to cause issues when you are trying to connect to your software via your computer. Just to the right of that, you will see the tripod screw, and that's a pretty standard tripod screw there. And just to the right of that, you will see a mini USB connector, and below that, you will see your charger connector. And all the associated cabling, whether it be the mini USB or the charger, should come with your SMP2 as well as your field probes. Okay, so that should just about wrap it up for the bottom side of the SMP2 meter. Now let's go ahead and let's take a look at the top side. I'm just showing everyone how to make the different connections to switch out the different probes. All right, here you're gonna find the top side of your Wave Control SMP2 field meter. So when you are switching out probes, you just wanna line up a little notch with a little extended piece on the field probe itself. So let's go ahead and turn the meter on the side real quick and see if you can't notice that little notch cut out right there. All right, and the probe just lines up right in there. So let's go ahead and let's do that right now. Let's go ahead and line the notches up right there. All right, you should see it slide right in like that. Make sure it's kind of pushed all the way down in the corresponding position, and then tighten the threading. All right, perfect, just like that. The same methodology is used to remove it, just obviously in reverse. Okay, so now that should just about wrap up changing the different probes in and out of the SMP2 field meter. Let's go ahead and let's boot up the field meter and take a look at some of the different options from the display. Okay, here you're going to find the front panel display for the SMP2 field meter. There's two different kind of subcategories here, measurements and system. Today we're going to focus heavily on the measurement options, but you can see there, you can take a look at the measurement log, which is going to be your saved data, as well as your probe and settings there. So now let's go ahead and click OK, take a look at the measurement options. And these are just going to be different criteria, which are going to be kind of presented uniformly throughout your testing. So you see right there, measurement type, save samples every 0.5 inches, and just a variety of other criteria right there. So you can scroll down and take a look at all those. Again, this may or may not be required for your testing. However, this is just going to be a brief overview. If you are going out there and you are conducting testing, the user manual is also a great resource. So let's just go ahead and change this samples every, let's go ahead and change that to 1 inches. And you will see that indicated orange there when you are selected to a particular dropdown or data. So and you should see that change when you do change the value. All right, so that should be just about it for measurement options. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the measurement screen. So if you hit your home key one more time at the bottom, you should see a general display that looks something like this kind of pop up. Kind of taking a look at the top side of the system first, in the upper right-hand corner, you'll see the battery icon. That's pretty straightforward. You see right now there's an 80% charge. If you do see that go down, it should be about 7 hours, I believe it said, for a full charge. However, you know, if you need to charge it quickly to get some more testing done, it's typically pretty quick. Taking a look just below there, you should see the probe, and you will see the frequency range indicated.
1 hertz to 400 kilohertz. So as I mentioned previously, we are using the WP400 for the video today, and that probe does cover the frequency range of 1 kilohertz to 400 kilohertz. Just below that, you will see the measurement information right there. You'll see we have a max hold. Right now it's running. It's at 58 inches. Just below that, you will see your measurement information. So you see right there, we are looking at 15.16, and then 25.26. And we do have our hold in place right now. And you just see just below those values, you will see our graph given our frequency range we have selected. So there's one more area we want to touch base on just real quickly, and this is going to be the scroll menu at the bottom. So right now you should see menu, log, field, and more. So for today's video, we're really not going to go too deep into these sub menus here. However, it is good to know this is where you find some of this information. So when you take a look at menu on the left side, that's going to take you back to the home screen. Your log is going to be to save any information on your screen, and your field is just adjusting the measurement type. So you see right there, we have E or H because our WP400 can measure both fields. We're going to leave it on E. So taking a look here, you will see more, 1 of 4. I'm not sure if you can see it. However, if you select that button right there, you'll see additional information. So you'll see mode right there. And there's three different modes that the Wave Control SMP2 provides. And that's going to be time, FFT, and frequency log. So those are available for you. We're going to go ahead and close that out there. And then span, limit, units, hold, filter, and then finally reset and axis. So there are four different series of options there, which you can change to meet the particular testing requirements or needs that you're looking to do. Okay, so that should just about wrap it up from the front panel here. If you start from the beginning here, one thing you do want to be aware of, and that's going to be your hold right there. You'd switch that off just like that. When you do select it, you should see it change on the display. So you see the little max has disappeared, and then the screen is saying setting it back up. So now you're going to see some movement in the values. Okay, so that should just about wrap it up right now from the front panel display. Now let's go ahead and let's connect our SMP2 field meter with our associated probe using our fiber optic cable to our laptop, and let's go ahead and get the software booted up.
All right, here you're going to find the SMP2 reader software, and right now we're looking at the live measurement section. So this is very similar to the front panel display of the SMP2, where we modified some of those different testing criteria. So taking a look in the middle, you'll see the RMS in volts per meter. You'll see that kind of moving as we don't have a hold set on it right now. Just next to that, up in the right, you'll see the filter. Following that, you'll see the span and then any limits in place. Just below that, you'll find the mode and fields, and you'll see E and H are available. And just like the front panel, there is an option to screen capture, just taking down that information so you can access it later. And then just below that, that's going to be your FFT axis choice, whether it's total, X, Y, or Z, and a little associated graph. So the next tab is going to be the SMP2 information tab. That's going to include a little bit about the device, the SMP2, the serial number, the hardware version, data usage, and battery life. So the next one is going to be screenshots. So when you do go out there and you do take a screenshot with your SMP2 field meter using the front panel display, you can access those screenshots later. This is particularly useful if you want to show the exact measurement, what the screen looked like, as well as some of the associated information. So you can see right here on the right side, we just saved one of the screenshots from the video we did earlier. So the next one is going to be measurements. And this is where, if you saved it again on your SMP2 field meter, this is where the measurements are saved. And you can see on the right side, you have some information from one we did earlier with our FFT, X, Y, and Z values, as well as some measurement information about the probe and the frequency and stuff along those lines. You can see a graph as well. However, when you do want to export the selected data set, you just go ahead and go down the left corner, hit export selected right there, and select the associated folder.
So this is great if you do want to pull the data from your S&P 2 field meter into Excel or into a different program that's going to allow you to take a look at some different values. Okay, so that should be just about it for the S&P 2. During today's video, we walked through a little bit about the field monitor, how to connect different probes. We walked through the front panel display, and then we just finished walking through briefly about the S&P 2 reader software. We hope this video has been useful, and please don't hesitate to reach out if you're in need of any rental wave control equipment.